गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज माय लेक्चर नंबर 1 फॉर क्लास 11th सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश फॉर चैप्टर नंबर 3 डिस्कवरिंग टूट द सागा कॉन्टिन्यूज रिटन बाय A.R. विलियम्स. चिल्ड्रन, दिस इज चैप्टर नंबर 3 टेकन फ्रॉम योर बुक हॉर्नबिल. इन दिस चैप्टर आई विल लेट यू नो अबाउट इट्स इंट्रोडक्शन एंड देन I'll give you the explanation of this chapter precisely. And at the end, I'll assign you homework as well. I hope you will be enjoying listening and understanding this chapter. So children, let's begin with the introduction of this lesson, Discovering Toot, the Saga Continues. This chapter is written by A.R. Williams. And in this chapter is about the last year of the powerful pharaoh dynasty, Tutankhamun, who died when he was a teenager after ruling for 9 years. You need to understand, the last year of pharaoh dynasty named Tutankhamun died when he was a teenager, and by that time he just ruled for 9 years, and his death was a mystery because he died in a mysterious way. And this chapter throws light over all the possible mysteries, whether it was a curse, where his tomb lies, his life, and his untimely death. Egyptians believed that there is life after death. And that is the reason why the pharaohs were buried with wealth and everyday use items. Children, the title of this chapter means Discovering Tut, means the mummy of this, the powerful pharaoh's dynasty last successor, that was Tutankhamun, that is nicknamed as Tut, was discovered. And his mummy was discovered, and after that there are so many mummies which would be experimented upon. So children, the chapter begins with Tut, the last successor of Pharaoh dynasty. And the chapter begins that he was just a teenager. Here he refers to Tut. And the chapter begins that he was just a teenager when he died. And the last year here means inheritor or successor of a powerful family that had ruled Egypt and its empire for centuries. He was laid to rest leaden. Leaden means loaded. He was laid to rest loaded with gold and eventually forgotten. Since the discovery of his tomb in 1922, the modern world has speculated about what happened to him, with murder being the most extreme possibility. Now, leaving his tomb for the first time in almost 80 years, Tut has undergone a CT scan that offers new clues about his life and death and provides precise data for an accurate forensic reconstruction of the boyish pharaoh. Now, forensic reconstruction means the process of recreating the face of an individual. I repeat, forensic reconstruction means the process of recreating the face of an individual. And Pharaoh is a ruler in ancient Egypt, right? So in this, the chapter begins about the description of Tut, that he was just a teenager when he died. He was the last successor of a powerful dynasty that had ruled Egypt and its empire for centuries. And when he died, he was just a teenager, and his dead body was laden with, means loaded with gold, and then he was eventually forgotten. Then The discovery of his tomb happened in 1922, and the modern world has speculated about what happened to him. They wanted to know the reason of his death at a very young age, because he had just ruled for 9 years and he died. As he was the last successor of his family, so his death became a mystery. Whether it was a murder or he died naturally is the question for the people to find his mummy, and they started working on it to know that the reason of his death was whether a murder or he died naturally. Then we proceed further with the lines. An angry wind stirred up ghostly dust. Devils, as King Tut was taken from his resting place in the ancient Egyptian cemetery known as the Valleys of the Kings. Now you need to understand, stirred means move or cause to move slightly. Ghostly means unnatural, unreal. Resting place means his grave, where he was buried, his dead body was buried. Cemetery means a large burial ground. Dark bellied clouds had skirted and across the desert sky all day and now were veiling the stars in the casket grey. Dark bellied means dark in color. Scudded across means moving quickly. It refers to the movement of the dark bellied clouds. Veiling means to cover something. Casket means a small ornamental box or chest for holding jewels, letters or other valued objects. Casket grey means the grey clouds were like a grey colored casket which contained the stars. The stars are like jewels which are kept in the casket. Then he writes, it was 6 p.m. on January 5, 2005. The world's most famous mummy glided head first into a CT scanner brought here to probe the lingering medical mysteries of this little understood young ruler who died more than 3,300 years ago. Now glided means continuous motion. Probe means to investigate or to find out. Lingering means long lasting. So in this second stanza, the writer wants to explain that a fast, strange and unnatural wind was blowing as King Tut's body was taken from his grave called Valleys of the Kings. An ancient Egyptian cemetery, the location of the Valley of the Kings is given in this image. Dark clouds moved quickly across the desert all day long and later they covered the stars. On January 5, 2005 at 6 p.m., King Tut's mummy, which is the world's most famous mummy, was placed in the CT scanner to investigate the mystery behind his death, which had occurred more than 3,300 years ago. Now, the author describes the condition of the mummy. All afternoon, the usual line of tourists from around the world had descended into the cramped rock-cut tomb some 26 feet underground to pay their respects. Descendant means moved or gathered. Cramped means very small to fit into. Rock-cut means made in a rock by cutting it. They gazed. Gazed means to look in surprise or in admiration. They gazed. Gazed means to look in surprise or in admiration. They gazed at the murals on the walls. Now murals. Mural means a painting or other artwork executed directly on the wall. So the people had been gazing at the murals on the walls of the burial chamber and peered at Tut's gilded face. The most striking feature of his mummy, shaped outer coffin lid. Gilded means covered with thin sheet or coating of gold. Some visitors read from guidebooks in a whisper. Others stood silently, perhaps pondering. Pondering means thinking. Toad's untimely death in his late teens, or wondering with a shiver if the Pharaoh's curse, death or misfortune falling upon those who disturbed him, was really true. Now, in these lines, the author writes that all afternoon, tourists visited the 26 feet deep underground rock cut tomb to pay respect to the king. Many people stuffed into the small tomb and looked in admiration at the murals on the walls of the chamber and took a look at the face of Tut that had been painted with gold. While visitors read the guidebooks in a hushed tone, some stood silently, wondering about his untimely death in his teen years. They might also be wondering if the curse of the Pharaoh, which leads to his descent of misfortune upon the person who disturbed him, is true. Then he writes, "The mummy is in very bad condition because of what Carter did in the year 1920, said Zahi Hawass, Secretary General of Egypt's Supreme Council of Antiquities, as he leaned over the body for a long first look. Carter, Howard Carter, that is, was the British archaeologist who in 1922 discovered Tut's tomb after years of futile searching. Futile means pointless, incapable of producing the result of something. Its contents, though hastily ransacked in antiquity, were surprisingly complete." Children, the meaning of hastily means fastly, swiftly. Antiquity means age or oldness, and ransacked means raid, go through a place to steal or damage something. Then they remain the richest royal collection ever found and have become part of the Pharaoh's legend. Stunning artifacts in gold, their eternal brilliance meant to guarantee resurrection, caused a sensation at the time of the discovery. Resurrection means restoration of life. Then, and still get the most attention. But Tut was also buried with everyday things he would want in the afterlife. Board games, a bronze razor, linen, undergarments, cases of wood and wine. Afterlife means life after death. In these lines, the writer says, as Zahi Hawass, Secretary General of Egypt, leaned over the body to have a look, he said that the condition of mummy was very bad because of what the British archaeologist Howard Carter did to it in the 1920s. He discovered King Tut's tomb in 1922 after a long search. The valuable treasures of Tut had been explored earlier too, but surprisingly, they were complete. The treasure found at Tut's grave is the richest till date and has come to be known as the Pharaoh's legend. It has artifacts in gold which were eternally beautiful and as good as new. Such artifacts still get attention. Tut was buried with things of daily use like a razor made of bronze, games, linen undergarments, and boxes of food and wine which he could use in the next life. This was all the belief of his dynasty, that all the royals were buried with the daily use things, so that if they need them, it was believed that they would need all these things even after their life. Now, analysis of Tut's grave by the archaeologists. After months of carefully recording the Pharaoh's funerary treasures, Carter began investigating his three nested coffins. Funerary treasures means the valuable things with which the king was buried. Three nested coffins means three coffins placed one in another in order of decreasing size, the innermost coffin housed the body of the deceased. So, the writer says, opening the first, he found a shroud adorned with garlands of willows and the olive leaves. He found a shroud. Shroud means a length of cloth in which a dead person is wrapped. Adorned means decorated. With garlands of willows. Garlands of willow means a wreath of flowers and leaves. And olive leaves, wild celery, lotus petals and cornflowers, the faded evidence of a burial in March or April. Then the writer says, when he finally reached the mummy, though he ran into trouble, the ritual resins had hardened, cementing to the bottom of his solid gold coffin. No amount of legitimate force could move them. Carter wrote later, what was to be done? In these lines, the writer explains, Carter took a few months to record the treasures found in Tut's grave. Then he began investigating his three coffins which were nested one in another. In the first coffin, he could find a piece of cloth with garlands of willow, olive leaves, wild celery, lotus petals and cornflowers, which suggested that he had been buried in the month of March or April. When he reached the third coffin, he was in trouble. The body had hardened due to the resins which had cemented the body, and it had stuck to the bottom of the coffin, which was made of gold. Carter wondered what to do next, because no amount of force could separate the two. In next lines, it is written, the sun can beat down like a hammer this far south in Egypt, and Carter tried to use it to loosen the resins. For several hours, he set the mummy outside in blazing sunshine. Blazing means very hot, almost burning. Sunshine that heated it to 149 degrees Fahrenheit, nothing budged. Budged means moved or shifted. There was no slight movement noticed by him after the body was kept in the blazing sunshine that heated it to 149 degrees Fahrenheit. He reported with scientific detachment that the consolidated material had to be chiseled away from beneath the limbs and trunk before it was possible to raise the king's remains. Chiseled away means to cut something with the help of a chisel. So Carter tried to loosen the resins by keeping the body in the hot sun. He kept the mummy in 149 degrees Fahrenheit for several hours, but still it remained stuck. He reported that a chisel could be used to cut down the mummy from the limbs and the trunk so that Tut's body could be taken out of his coffin. Now, in his defense, Carter really had little choice. If he had not cut the mummy free, thieves most certainly would have circumvented the guards and ripped it apart to remove the gold. Circumvented means find a way around. Thieves would have found a way to tackle the guards and remove the gold from the tomb, because it was clearly written that the body of Tut was gilded with gold. It was all covered with gold. So Carter had no choice. He had very little choice. Then he thought, if he had not cut the mummy free, then there was a danger of getting the jewels or the gold stolen by the thieves. In Tut's time, the royals were fabulously wealthy, and they thought or hoped they could take their riches with them. For his journey to the great beyond, King Tut was lavished with glittering goods, precious collars, inlaid necklaces and bracelets, rings, amulets, a ceremonial apron, sandals, sheaths for his fingers and toes, and the new iconic inner coffin and mask. All these things were of pure gold. Now I tell you the meanings of inlaid. Inlaid means a decorative pattern on a surface. Amulet means an ornament or small piece of jewelry thought to give protection against evil, danger or disease. Jisko aap tabiz bolte ho. Apron. Apron means a protective garment worn over the front of one's clothes and tied at the back. Sheaths. Sheath means a close-fitting cover. Iconic. Iconic means something or someone who is a symbol or it represents something, adornments, means ornaments. Then, to separate Tut from his adornments, means his ornaments, Carter's men removed the mummy's head and severed nearly every major joint. Once they had finished, they reassembled the remains on a layer of sand in a wooden box with padding that concealed the damage. Concealed means hid. The bed where Tut now rests. So in these lines, it is written that according to Carter, he had no choice other than to cut the mummy. He believed that if he had not done that, thieves would have removed the gold from the tomb and would have looted it. During Tut's time, the royal people were very wealthy and they had a belief that after death, they could take the wealth along with them. For his life after death, he was given precious collars, necklaces with decorative patterns, bracelets, rings, amulets, ceremonial aprons, sandals, sheaths for his fingers and toes, and now an iconic inner coffin and a mask. His men removed his head and every joint of his body. After they finished, they reassembled the remains in a wooden box with padding filled with a layer of sand to conceal the damage, to hide the damage to that mummy. It was now Tut's new resting place. Now children, let me recapitulate the first half of the chapter for your better understanding. In this first half of the chapter, I taught you, discovering Tut, the saga continues, tells us that the last year or the last successor of the powerful Pharaoh dynasty was Tutankhamun, who is referred to as Tut. In the entire chapter, he is known as Tut, that was his nickname, and his complete name was Tutankhamun. And he was the last successor of his powerful dynasty, and he died in a mysterious way when he was a teenager after ruling just for 9 years. And there was the curse where his tomb lies, his life and untimely death. Egyptians believe that there is life after death, therefore all the gilded ornaments had been buried along with his dead body in his coffin, and he was kept with the things of daily use because it was the belief of the people of his dynasty that the kings like Tut needed all those things even after their life. And then he tells us about the Tut who was the last successor of Pharaoh dynasty. Pharaoh dynasty ruled Egypt and its empire for centuries, and Tutankhamun was heavily loaded with gold, and his tomb was discovered in 1922 by an archaeologist named Howard Carter. And his body was taken from the cemetery that was called Valleys of the King, where all the dead bodies of kings were buried, was taken out in 1922. Then King Tut's mummy was placed in the CT scanner to investigate the mystery behind his death. Then the author describes the condition of his mummy, that when this mummy was brought, Then the tourists also got wondered about the curse of the Pharaoh. Zahi Hawass, who was the Secretary General of Egypt, commented about the bad condition of this mummy. He said the treasure was found at Tut's grave was the richest till date and was known as Pharaoh's legend. Tut was buried with things like a razor made of bronze, games, boxes of food, wine, etc. Then the archaeologists analyzed the Tut's grave and they come to know that he might have been buried in the months of March or April. Then they checked the coffin. The coffin had three layers and in third coffin the body had hardened due to the resins which had cemented the body to the bottom. According to Howard Carter, he had no choice other than to cut the mummy as thieves would have removed the gold from the tomb and looted it. Because to separate the tomb from to separate the body from its coffin, he had to keep it into the blazing sunshine so that the body gets separated from its coffin. But in that experiment, he also got failed. Then he had no other choice to cut the mummy with the help of a chisel. His men removed the mummy's head and every joint of his body was reassembled. It was kept in such a way that he wanted to hide the damage to the body. And the archaeologist got to know about all this damage when they started investigating upon it again. So this is what the complete explanation, children, we studied from page number 22 to 25. Now, homework of the day. Children, you all are supposed to read word to word from page number 22 to 25 till the second stanza ends on page number 25 of chapter number 3, Discovering Tut, the saga continues, thoroughly and attentively. By the time, have a nice day, have a good day.